In this episode of the DevOps Lab, I have with me Dan Hellem, and today we're going to dive in and talk about the basic process in Azure DevOps. Hi, welcome to the DevOps Lab. Today we have as our guest Dan Hellem. Dan?
Thanks, Abel. Yeah, my name is Dan Hellem. I am a program manager on the Azure DevOps team. I'm here to talk today about our new process that we rolled out called BASIC.
So, all right. I've seen this kind of fly through a little bit. Explain to me, what is this BASIC process? Why do we even have it? Why do we need it?
Good. Yeah, so this has actually been an interesting journey. Like, we've been talking about putting out the BASIC process for actually a couple years now. Mm-hmm. So if we kind of take a look from a lens from a new person coming into Azure DevOps, right now we have three processes. We got Agile, we have Scrum, we have CMMI, right?
Right.
And the problem with those are is they're very process or methodology heavy.
Sure.
Right. So if I'm a new engineer and I'm working on GitHub stuff and I come over and I want to use Azure DevOps, I really you're going to make me use product backlog items and user stories and all those kind of weird terminology. And what we found is as new engineers come in and they start using the product, they start dropping off because the stuff is just too complicated.
Right.
And so what we decided, and especially as we did kind of did the GitHub acquisition, is like we really want engineers to use the product and love the product, and a way to do that is kind of get rid of the extra baggage that comes with like the Agile and Scrum and CMMI, and just make it easy, right? I just want to start doing work. I just want to add issues to my project and start getting things done. And so that's essentially what we did.
Very cool. Very cool. So can you kind of show us what this basic process
is
like?
Yeah. So what I'll do is I'll start with I have an organization already created. Mm-hmm. We're going to go ahead and create a new project.
All right.
And we'll just call this basic demo.
Okay.
Right. You can see here that the default is now basic. So for all new accounts, so anybody who creates a new organization, the default will be basic all the time unless people change it.
Okay.
So we'll go ahead and create the new basic project.
Okay.
And as that's going, you'll notice here is when we kind of create the project, the number of work item type concepts has gone from 15 to like 3.
Wow.
So we only have 3 work item types now. So let's go drop into our boards real quick. And the states are also just as simple. So now here we are. I'm on an issues board. Mm-hmm. Issues are kind of like the primary central focus point for when you start with the basic process.
Okay.
So that's what people are used to, right? If you come from things like Jira, you come from GitHub. People understand and know the terminology issues, so that's why we chose issues.
Okay.
We also have states in there for just to-do, doing, and done. So again, we got rid of some of the complexities that come with like Scrum and all the different types of states that come there. And so here I'll just go ahead and quickly create a new item. Right. So issues, again, everything works the same.
Okay.
It's just different type. And so I can go ahead and break this down with tasks if I want to go ahead and add tasks. So tasks are also kind of like your central focus point if you're doing things like iterations and sprints, right?
Right.
Or if you just want to break it down into a to-do list.
Okay.
The state model for that is also to-do, doing, and done. So the state model across all 3 work item types is exactly the same.
Yep.
You also notice as I open up the work item type itself is like it's super simple, right? I don't have a bunch of extra fields, things like business value and all that stuff that really nobody really knows what it is. Mm-hmm. We decided to just wicked simple, but yet not break anything that's in the software.
Right.
So things like priority is a field that people can relate to, right? How do I prioritize? Effort is something that is needed for things like when I do my burn downs, right? So we need to keep that. But for the most part, we just simplify the heck out of it and only provided a few extra fields.
Yeah. So I kind of get this idea of, we want to simplify this process for the people that don't need a super heavy, rule-driven process like Agile or Scrum. And issues make sense, right? We've got an issue coming, we've got to address this. Is there a way for me to plan or track my work if things are like bigger than like one sprint, bigger than just an issue that we need to fix?
Yeah, absolutely. So if we take a look at, let's just go take a look at the backlog.
Okay.
So you can see here, like here I have my issues and it's obviously it's breakdown. Mm-hmm. Oops, wrong button. So here I have my issue, I have my task. I can also go ahead and do things like create a new, we can go to do epics, right? So you can roll your issues up to epics.
Okay.
Right? And so the idea then is if I want to create a new epic, add to the top, right? So now I can have a board that keeps track of my higher level monster items, and then I can execute on my issues board.
Got it.
And then you can have that hierarchy where tasks roll up to issues and issues roll up to tasks. Yep. So you have that nice roll up feature as well.
Nice.
If you want to use it. We found that most people who are, you know, come from these smaller places don't necessarily use epics very often.
Right.
But for those groups that do, they obviously, their decision is they can go ahead and use those epics as needed.
So is there still a concept of like I can work in sprints, or is that gone?
Yeah, no, so we still have sprint planning. All the fields are there, so the sprint planning still works. So you can add your issues into the sprint, which you can see here that I have a sprint, and I can execute on the sprint. So again, the functionality inside Azure DevOps is exactly the same.
Okay.
The idea is that here is we just have simpler work item types and a lot less of them.
Once again, streamlining this whole work item tracking experience.
Exactly.
So what about customization?
Yeah.
How much can I customize this basic process?
So customization is still exactly the same as it has been. You can go ahead, and so we find that you're exactly right. Like, hey, I come in and I start tracking work and I realize, you know what, I need a couple extra fields to start tracking stuff for me or whatever it might be.
Right.
So I can come in here and still do that same thing that I do now, where I come into process, and you'll see now basic is a list, and if I want to create a new inherited process from here, I can create a new inherited process.
Yeah. And then so this is all the same as before.
Yeah, exactly. So just to kind of give you an idea, basic test, can't use the same name there. And if you come in here, obviously you can see that the work item types is obviously a lot less. We really only have the three active work item types. I can add new work item types, I can customize the existing work item types, I can add new levels if I wanted to do that type of work.
Nice,
yep.
Nice. So this is fantastic. Is this live now?
Yeah, so this is live now. All existing accounts will have have basic as the fourth process, right? And now we're in the process of rolling it out where when you acquire a new organization, it automatically creates a new project as basic and automatically makes it the default. We're still trying to get through some technical funness through there, but that should roll out within the next week or two, and then everybody in the whole world, anytime they create a new project from the beginning, will have basic as a default, or if they create a new organization, basic will be the default.
That is awesome.
Yeah.
So, call to action. What do we want people to do?
Yeah, so I think the main thing is we just want to hear from folks, right? If people are having trouble with it or have questions on it or maybe they don't like something, to send us feedback on that. The call to action is really go out, create a new project, create a new organization, get your friends to use it, obviously. But then if people have questions, like just hit us again on Twitter. You can hit me directly at Dan Hellem on Twitter. We can hit the Azure DevOps at Twitter. Hit Abel, hit Donovan, hit anybody you want. We're here to collect feedback and obviously make it better.
Absolutely. So let's start using this. This is awesome stuff, really, really good stuff. I'm super excited. Like Dan said, please give us feedback so we can make this like a top-notch, first-class experience. Tweet at Dan, tweet at me, at Abel Squidhead, tweet at Donovan, tweet whoever you can, at Azure DevOps, right?
Yep, exactly.
And let's make this a great experience. Thank you all.
Thank you.